Sunday afternoon with the NBA here on 2K Sports. Welcome, everyone. Joined by Richard Jefferson and Greg Anthony, I'm Kevin Harlan. David Aldridge is with us on the sidelines. A moment now to look at the year-to-year scoring output and how it has been trending for Andrew Wiggins.
And maybe it's shocking, maybe not too shocking, but the scoring trend over the last few years has been going down a bit. I'm sure it's something he's well aware of, and we'll see if that continues to be the case.
So with Paul on the bench, here's the group that Steve Kerr has on the floor. Out in the perimeter, Thompson and Wiggins. Kuminga out there with Draymond Green, and it's Curry in at the point guard position. And for Sacramento, Barnes is in the front court along with Murray. De'Aaron Fox out there with Ellis. And it's Sabonis in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. Conference rivals, Greg, butting heads in this one. How does that raise the stakes here?
Well, both teams want this one bad, and a chance to prove they're the dominant squad. I think it's going to get pretty heated at some point here tonight.
Outside, Fox. Pass to Barnes. Five to shoot. And there's the whistle. 3-second violation. Here's Curry. Pass to Green. Now Kuminga. Over Murray. Rebound by Murray. Ellis, the pass to Fox. Murray kicks to Fox. Murray dishes to Barnes. Over Wiggins. That one off the back iron and out. Talk about the value, Richard, of having a player like Harrison Barnes on your roster. It's immense.
He's a steady veteran who finds multiple ways to impact the game. It sets the tone for the rest of the guys out there. They know they have to work as hard as he does.
We play just over a minute here in the first. Thompson finds Kuminga. Green with the ball. Wiggins surveying the floor. Pass to Curry. Just five on the clock. Shoots over Fox. Thompson for the triple. That one's off. He starts the game with a miss.
And not allowing the shooter even an inch of breathing room on that one.
I'm sure they'll think twice about shooting against him next time.
And they don't want to get in a habit of giving him open looks from three. First quarter still, but not who you want to leave open.
And so it's Golden State with it. Sacramento able to drain the three. And there's the pass to Kuminga. The jump hook. That's in, and he found his range with that one. Now 1-for-2.
With all the attention Clay gets, it can lead to open looks for others. Nice decision.
The first quarter of action, 2 minutes in. Fox against Curry. Right side, Fox, and it's in there.
They've come out strong, three of their first four to start the game.
Warriors have gone 1-of-3 from the field to start this one so far. Pass to Curry. That one's in, his first shot this game.
Nice work from the in-between area. Curry has no problem taking this shot when it's available.
Outside, Sabonis. Back to Ellis. Launches it. It's rebounded by Golden State. Their last encounter was in San Francisco.
Well, I felt like they were never on the same page defensively in that one. Gave up way too many easy shots.
Well, they looked like they were asleep on that end of the floor. No one was talking. No one was paying attention. Yeah, it was rough.
Now, here's Ellis. 17 points in his last outing. On the wing, Barnes. 6 on the shot clock. Sabonis sets the pick for Barnes. Hits it from three-point range. Barnes has got 5.
Well, he is looking confident. Love how they're using him so far.
Yeah, when he gets engaged this early in the game, it's bad news for the defense. He can roll this start throughout the rest of the game.
And yes, records are made to be broken. But RJ made three-point shots. My goodness, Curry is so far ahead of everyone else.
Yeah, to me, it comes down to longevity. LeBron passed Kareem on all-time scoring lists, so anything is possible. But it's hard to pass Steph because he's just going to keep going.
Free throw good by Curry.
Perhaps the greatest shooter the game has ever seen. Curry continues to age like fine wine.
Looney's checked in for the Warriors. Paul comes in for Andrew Wiggins. And the second free throw, good. And Richard, for the Warriors, a number of future Hall of Famers playing a part. But Stephen Curry, we all know this, is the center of it all.
He's the greatest shooter ever, Kev. We all know that. But when people say that he changed the game, a lot of times I like to give credit to the entire team. Having Klay Thompson helped Steph be Steph. And having Draymond Green with that defense and his passing ability helped Steph's game go to another level.
Back from outside, and another three for Sacramento.
So good at getting to the bucket. That time, Fox pulls the string and leaves the defense high and dry.
Green with a screen on Fox. Puts it up from 12, and Paul gets it to go in. Kings leading now by 4. Fox feeling it out a bit. Curry against Mitchell. Out to the right wing. Shot clock at 6. McGee sets the pick for Fox. And McGee kicks to Lyles. Another 3 for Sacramento.
The defense a step slow, and you can see the result.
Here's Curry. He had a 33-point outing in their last game against New Orleans.
And how about the vision he displayed? Great job getting others involved and piling up the assist.
Now, here's Looney. Passes it to Thompson. Good! Great play by Green to set it up.
The moment that last 3 went in, Thompson must have been thinking, get me the ball, I'll answer it with a 3.
To the inside. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot 2. They get Stephen Curry.
And I like the fact that the defense is looking to protect the rim at all costs.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one. Free throw drops for Mitchell. Sabonis, he's checked in for Sacramento. Chris Duarte comes in for Fox. And Mitchell drops them both. Warriors trail by 6. Curry deciding where to go with it. From past the arc, that one doesn't go. And so it's Sacramento with their lead standing at 6 points here at the end of the quarter. They've done a lot of great work from long range. And we've got more M2K Sports coming your way after this break. And thanks again for tuning in. If you're just joining us, we've played through one quarter of action so far. And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. The scoring breakdown for Sacramento.
They've really been dialed in from deep. This is a team that has a ton of confidence in their outside shooting ability.
And you can't turn it over against this team. That's a recipe for disaster, and we're seeing the results of that.
Warriors trail by six. They've got Sabonis. Trey Lyles out there with Mitchell. And it's Vezenkov in at the three, the small forward. That's the five to begin the second quarter for the Kings. Charge, a screen on Mitchell. Paul against Mitchell. Fades. Paul can't get it to go.
And the fadeaway was the only option he had on that one. Defender there all over.
Paul against Mitchell. Pass to Sabonis. The shot misses. Some solid defense from Šarić. Here's Podziemski. And it's Sacramento with the rebound.
And he's usually able to score on that type of defense rather easily. Surprising to see him come away empty.
Mitchell looking it over. Takes it inside. The pass to Duarte. Lets the three fly. Podziemski grabs the board. Last outing for Golden State, it was a loss to New Orleans. Pass to Paul. Here's Podziemski for the three, drills the three-pointer. Podziemski's got the second quarter going with the first basket of the period for the Warriors. And as the season draws to a close, GA, we've got teams vying for playoff position, only adding to the importance of each game now.
And for those teams, you have to have the right mentality. You can't treat these like normal regular season games. These are an extension of the playoffs.
Gotta love a big who can also move the ball. Nice find by Sabonis.
Keegan Murray's checked in for the Kings. Ellis comes in for Duarte. Warriors trail by six. Paul outside. Looney passes to Wiggins. Here's Curry. Curry gets it to go inside.
Such a quick release. As soon as the ball touches his hands, it's gone.
Murray outside. Back to Mitchell. Sacramento moving it around. Murray kicks to Lyles. Ellis outside. It's stolen by Curry. Oh, Curry is so dangerous in transition.
And once Curry swipes it, he's off to the races. Terrific initiative.
And it's Mitchell with the ball for Sacramento. Last game matchup with the Suns, a tough loss there.
Yeah, they made some spectacular plays in it right to the very end. Just couldn't get over the hump.
And that is why coaches preach about the details. The margins in this league are razor thin.
Now here's Wiggins. He had an 18-point outing in the last game against New Orleans.
And it's the way he stayed aggressive in getting to the foul line that was impressive. But he also did a superb job in cashing in from the foul line.
Now here's Mitchell following the shot by Chris Paul. Mitchell passes to Lyles. Murray outside. To the middle. Here's Mitchell. Good, and the assist goes to Murray. And the Kings lead by four.
And that's an example of playing big, adapting to the situation.
Also relying on his skill there. That's a nice move against Lang.
Now here's Wiggins. Hasn't made one yet. Inside. Murray, good.
Taking the hit there. Great concentration by Murray.
Warriors trail by six. And the Warriors decide to take their first time out here. Defeated by the Pelicans in their last game. They'll try to put that one behind them.
Yeah, lots of sloppy play in that one. Several key miscues they just couldn't overcome the mistakes.
Hopefully this is a reality check for them. Teams in this league are just too good. You will be punished for your mistakes.
And some changes here for the Kings. McGee, he's checked in for Sabonis. Harrison Barnes comes in for Trey Lyles. And it's Fox in for Mitchell. Draymond Green, he's checked in for the Warriors. Thompson comes in for Paul. Ellis against Thompson. Outside Curry. Passes it to Green. Back to Curry. From deep. Another three from Steph Curry. This guy is unreal.
What focus from Curry on offense so far. Doing everything he can to provide a lift for his squad.
Here's Murray again, Sacramento.
Just such a well-rounded offensive player. He's got a little bit of everything.
Curry against Fox. Poked loose. Stolen by Ellis. And the ball out of play. The Warriors will inbound. Here's Curry, 12 points for him. There's 18 seconds left here in the second. Kicks it to Kuminga. Now Green, lock at six, Thompson outside. Off target with his three. And a close game so far through the first two quarters as we reach halftime. Kings lead by five. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks very much, DeMontis. This team was efficient in the first half. What's working offensively?
Everyone knew today was going to be a game. We all came out focused on playing team basketball. We're sharing the ball, and that's working for us.
You've got a lot of weapons there, DeMontis. Thanks for your time. Back to you guys.
Thank you, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of action following halftime.
Ernie Johnson here with Kenny the Jet and the Big Diesel, Shaquille O'Neal. How about we start out with the Western Conference and how those teams are stacking up?
And taking a look at Sacramento, they've clearly taken a step back as a franchise. You hate to see that. But something isn't right with this team. I don't know if it's personnel, the coaching. They're going to have to make some changes in the offseason.
And let's get into this first half where there were some struggles, and it's a grim situation for Golden State.
Right now, it's about the lack of defense, or lack thereof, giving up too many wide-open looks. I'm not seeing any heart or any hustle.
Yeah, you can just imagine what coach is telling them in the locker room.
Thanks for joining us. Now let's toss it to Kevin Harlan for the start of the second half.
And after a fairly even first couple of quarters, the second half could turn out to be a great one as both teams try to gain an edge. Curry has been sensational.
Man, he's been running wild on them through that first half. Absolute dynamite on offense.
If they don't change their approach in the second half, let's just say his success will continue.
We've got second half action for you, and if the next couple quarters are similar to the first, this one could go down to the last possession. So with Paul on the bench, here's the group that Steve Kerr has on the floor. In the backcourt, it's Curry and Thompson. Wiggins is out there with Jonathan Kuminga, and it's Green in at the five down low. Wiggins finds Curry. Golden State needs to get off a shot. Just his first attempt. And it's Wiggins missing.
See, that miss right there. It's why teams try to avoid the mid-range jumper these days.
Sabonis is screen on Thompson. Fox passes to Sabonis. Stolen by Thompson. Green dishes to Curry. And Greg, when they talk about youth development, the days are gone when coaches divided guards and bigs when it comes to skill work. When did that change?
It's kind of a recent development, maybe the last 10 or 15 years, but it's amazing how the game has evolved.
And here is Murray after the three-pointer from Stephen Curry. The kick out to Fox. Murray is screen on Curry. Six to shoot. To come right back with a three of his own, but it's no good. Dishes it to Thompson. 90 seconds now into the second half. Curry can't get it to go. And it's Sabonis with the ball for Sacramento. A two-point game. They'll be playing host to Portland for their next game, and that'll be the fourth of this five-game homestand. Murray sets a screen for Fox. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. One thing that's really emerged, RJ, for De'Aaron Fox over the last few years is leadership.
Yeah, hey, when you combine great talent and maturity, your teammates will follow the example you set. And he is setting that example night in and night out.
Free throw good, Fox.
One of the fastest guys in the league. For Fox, it's about using his blinding quickness to his advantage on both ends of the floor.
Fox hits them both. Now, here's Curry. He's got 15. Timeout called the Warriors.
Adjustments are a part of the game, and the coach sees something he doesn't like here.
Yeah, this is a good opportunity to get your group together and make sure everyone is on the same page.
Moment now to look at the numbers for Sabonis, and he's in the top 10 in field goal percentage, really able to power his way to the bucket and finish through contact.
And just going back real quick to the fact that he's tops in the league in rebounds, what a tremendous feat. What a monster he is in the paint. 2 minutes into the second half of play now. Barnes against Wiggins. Outside Kerr. Pass to Kuminga. That one good for two.
That's a fantastic decision by Curry. Defense too focused in on Steph.
Sacramento's gone 5-9 when they put up the three-point shot tonight. Free throw line jump shot. That's good on the jump shot. Fox has got 9.
Found some space to get off the mid-range, and he'll do damage from there if you let him.
Pass to Curry. Puts up a 3. That's in, coming off the assist from Thompson. Thompson's got 3 assists now in this one. A little over 2.5 minutes off the clock in this final half of play. Outside, Sabonis. Back to Barnes. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. It's going to be on Andrew Wiggins. For Sacramento, they have hit all 4 of their chances so far in this one.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
And he makes the first. Trey Lyles checked in for Murray. And Golden State also making a change. Paul's checked in. Barnes hits them both. Warriors trail by 3. Third quarter here, and 3 minutes have come off the clock. Paul against Fox from deep. Green, and another 3 for Golden State.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. 4 of their last 5 makes are from beyond the arc. Talking about the grizzled veteran Draymond Green, still such an important player in this game.
Yeah, it's just because he's so unique. He doesn't look to score very often. His main focus continues to be on defense and his playmaking ability.
Here's Paul. After the basket by De'Aaron Fox. Paul passes to Thompson. He can't get that one to fall.
More good work on the glass there. When it's all said and done, I think rebounding might tell the story in this game.
Sabonis' screen on Paul. Fox. Draymond Green pulls it in. And so Green will bring it up for the Warriors. Trailing by 2. There's the pass to Kuminga. There's 57 seconds left in the third. And he gets the bucket. Thompson's got 5 now.
Those high percentage looks are easy for Thompson. He's just got the touch for inside shots.
Outside, Fox. Takes it from 10. No good off the back of the rim. Warriors have gotten 5 of 8 shots to fall for them in the third quarter. A nice 62% from the field. Green with a screen on Fox. Thompson outside for the lead. And another 3 for Golden State.
Let me just say this. Klay Thompson is one of about 10 people in NBA history that you do not want to leave open for a 3. The defense has to make it harder for him out there.
Now, here's Fox. He's got 11. 11 seconds left here in the third quarter. 5 on the clock. It's good. He's got 13.
We've seen Fox take over games before. Only takes a few shots to go, and then this man is feeling it.
And we just finished the third quarter, and we've got a tight ball game here. The Warriors on top. They're up by 1. Live from Golden 1 Center. You're watching 2K Sports. And a moment ago, inside the huddle with head coach Steve Kerr.
Great start, fellas. Clay, your cutting is awesome. Your movement without the ball is brilliant. Great stuff.
Good to hear that. Complimenting the motion, Steve Kerr likes this offense and how it's running right now.
And when the players and the ball never seem to stop, it really prevents a defense from getting set and digging in.
Well, this has been a great contest so far, and I imagine the fourth quarter could have even more action in store for us. They've got Mitchell. Sabonis is out there with Lyles. And it's Duarte in at the two. So that's the five in the game for Sacramento. Now here's Paul. Charge with the screen for Paul. Just five to shoot. The three. The shot by Sharks, no good. The Kings trailing. Mitchell outside. Pass Duarte. Sabonis with the ball. Defended by Looney. Here's Duarte. Sharks grabs the board. Golden State's gotten off 12 shots from beyond the arc tonight, hitting seven of them. Now the feed to Kerr. Sharge outside. Sharge with the screen for Kerr. Knocks down the three ball. Curry's got the lead up to four now for the Warriors.
They've given up a lot of three-pointers here today.
Duarte passes to Mitchell. Passes to Sabonis. Pass to Wiles. Count it and the foul. It's going to be on Sharks.
A true team first guy. Sabonis is always ready to share the ball.
Let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for the Warriors.
The name of the game in the modern NBA is making threes, spacing the court, and that's exactly what they are doing tonight.
And something else that stands out is how efficient they've been from the mid-range, making the most of their opportunities.
And the free throw, no good. Golden State's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Wiggins against Fox. Wiggins passes to Curry. No good with the triple. Kings have gone 1-3 from the field to start the fourth quarter. Sabonis sets the pick for Fox. And the pass to Sabonis. Now Lyles. And the call will be against Sabonis. That's foul number two for him.
The defenders need to recognize the importance of staying on him as we get into crunch time.
Barnes is checked in for Sacramento. The Warriors trailing. Just a little under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. Pass to Kerr from outside the arc. Off the mark for the fourth time this game. He is 7-for-11 now. Passes it to Fox. Tries from 16, and it's in. Basket number 6 for him thus far. He has only missed 2 shots from the floor.
What energy from Fox when they're up against it, proving he's ready to be that guy.
And Thompson kicks to Kurt. Green with a screen on Fox. Shot to stop the run. Out that one, and the Kings' lead has been cut to just 1 point on the basket from Stephen Curry.
I think we knew who was firing off the shot here. Curry is just too consistent not to be trusted with it.
Now, here's Fox. And there's Sabonis. That's good on the assist by Fox. Sabonis has got his first basket.
Answering the bell, Sabonis. Big time, guys.
Warriors trail by 3. Well, if you're just tuning in, welcome. We've got about 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. Green with a screen on Fox. It's Curry outside. He makes his 9th shot of the game. He has only missed 4.
And perimeter scoring, I have to imagine it was a topic of discussion at halftime.
And you see this so much more nowadays in the NBA. Teams putting a larger emphasis on jacking up threes.
And here is Fox after the three-pointer from Stephen Curry.
And such a clutch shooter. I mean, he lives with a big shot. And when he's rolling like this, watch out.
Curry against Fox. Curry kicks to Thompson. Now here's Kuminga. He's covered by Murray. Curry passes to Green. Kicks it out to Wiggins. Laces one from three.
And you can't get a bigger bucket than that.
What a huge play coming through when it matters most.
Sacramento's gone 6 of 10 from three-point range, up over 50% for the ballgame. Timeout called by the Kings. They're trailing by one. There's 53 seconds left to play in the final quarter.
A moment now to hear from our sideline reporter, Hall of Famer, David Aldridge. David.
Hey, guys, during the break, listened in to Mike Brown. Now, they told the team, we're winning this game with our defense. All we need is a couple of stops. Keep your focus. We'll see if they can close it out. Kevin?
Okay, David, thanks. There's 53 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Sabonis' screen on Curry. Money!
Keeping them in this. Sabonis showing no fear, taking the big shot.
Timeout called the Warriors. They're down by one. 44 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
44 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Thompson inside the line. It's hauled in by the Kings. And now the pass break. Fox with the ball. Murray, no good.
Outstanding work to send him away. They sniff that one out.
Here's Curry. Good!
When it is crunch time and you've got Stephen Wardell Curry, the game plan is simple. Get him the ball.
Now a timeout called by Sacramento. They trail by one. There's 25 seconds left in the game. There's 25 seconds left in the fourth. Curry against Fox. Murray a screen on Curry. Here's Fox.
And this is the trust that Fox's teammates have in him. What a shot right there.
Timeout called the Warriors. They're trailing by one. 12 seconds left in the fourth quarter. What's your take, guys?
Yeah, always intriguing to see what a coach draws up in this situation.
If they've got a surefire quick bucket play, let's just say now's the time to use it.
Curry against Fox. Up top, Curry. Here's Kuminga. Oh, the all-or-nothing shot. No good. So it's the Kings taking the W in a close one. What a show they put out here at home tonight.
I mean, these are those games that feel so great to win and really
it's like a knife in the gut to lose. You got to love being on edge of your seat and just wondering what's going to happen. How is this thing going to play out?
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. This is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. Now, let's check out our New Balance Player of the Game, De'Aaron Fox.